So I realized that I've been putting all this effort into learning about editing, yet I never talk about it. I guess that's mostly because I don't want to be that jerk who goes around giving unsolicited criticisms of perfectly understandable writing just because it doesn't technically follow the rules. The job of an editor is to give writers who ask help to present the best possible version of their work, not to judgmentally pass down rules from on high. Luckily, there's one thing I learned about that doesn't have much of anything to do with rules, and that's alt codes. Alt codes are a quick and easy way to type special characters that don't have dedicated keys on your keyboard. To type alt codes, you're going to need a computer that runs Windows. If you don't have that, then you want to skip ahead to the section on macOS and Linux. Now, look at my keyboard. You want to make sure that the number lock is on. Otherwise, there's a chance of your computer interpreting some of the symbols you type as commands, which can make a mess of things. If the numlock light isn't on, you can turn it on by pressing the numlock key here. Now that the number lock is on, what you want to do is hold down one of the alt keys, either will do, and type a sequence of numbers on the number pad. Once you've typed the code, release the alt key and your special character will appear. It's very important that you use the number pad on the right and not the row of numbers at the top. The numbers at the top will not work. That is, unless you have an FN key. If you're using a laptop or a TKL keyboard, you want to hold down Alt and FN while you type your alt code. That should work according to Wikipedia, though don't quote me on that as I don't have the equipment to test it. Now, alt codes are great, but they're very limited. These days, people prefer to use Unicode to type their special characters. Windows has extended things a bit by adding alt codes with a leading zero, but it isn't the same as Unicode. Windows also supports a system that lets you input Unicode using a decimal format, but in addition to being inconvenient as Unicode strings are written in hexadecimal, this system is limited to certain applications like Microsoft Word. If you want to enable proper Unicode functionality on your Windows computer, you will need to get just a little bit techy. You'll want to go to something called a registry editor, which you should be able to find in your computer's search bar. When you open it, you'll find a really big file directory, so it might take some time, but just scan through until you find a folder called Control Panel. Then open that and find a folder called Input Method. You'll want to click on it. Now, right-click on some empty space to bring up New and create a string value. Make sure that the string type is regsz, that's reg underscore sz. If it isn't, you selected the wrong type of string and you need to create a new string of the type string value. Now you need to right-click on the new string, which should be called new value number 1. Select rename, then type enable hex numpad with a capital E, capital H, a capital N, and no B in num. Next, right-click on your newly renamed string and select modify. In the box called value data, type a number 1. Once you've done that, click OK. Now all you need to do is either restart your computer or sign out and back in. You should now be able to type Unicode using hexadecimal input by holding down Alt, hitting the plus key to indicate that you're typing a Unicode string rather than an alt code, entering your code, letters included, and then releasing the Alt key. Just keep in mind that Google Chrome has shortcuts involving the Alt key and the letters D, E, and F, which can mess with Unicode. So you need to disable those shortcuts if you want to properly use Unicode in Google Chrome. To disable those shortcuts, you'll need an extension called Shortkeys, which I've linked in the description below. Once you've added it, you need to click on the three dots in the top right of Google Chrome, mouse over More Tools, and click on Extensions. Then you need to click on the three horizontal bars in the top left and select Keyboard Shortcuts. Finally, scroll down to Utility. Do nothing, disable browser shortcuts, experimental, and click on the pencil icon next to the box. Hold down Alt and hit D, and the command will be entered into the box. Do the same for E and F. Then you can use Unicode in Google Chrome without any interference. If you're using macOS, Linux, or any other Unix or Unix-like operating system, things are a lot simpler for you. You don't have alt codes, but you have full Unicode support, which is way better. All you need to do is hold down Ctrl, Shift, and U, then release them, type your code, then hit the spacebar or the Enter key. Easy! At least, that's what Wikipedia says, but I don't have a macOS or Linux device to test this with, so do not quote me on that, and apologies if it doesn't work out. So why use Alt Codes or Unicode? Well, there are a lot of applications for maths and linguistics, but for most users, the appeal of Alt Codes and Unicode is having easy access to those one or two symbols you use a lot and don't have keys for. For example, the different kinds of dashes. I said this wasn't going to be about editing. I lied. A huge pet peeve of mine, as someone who's studying to be an editor, is seeing people use hyphens as dashes. A hyphen might look close enough to an N dash or an M dash to be used as a stand-in, but it's really not. All of these symbols have distinct meanings. You have no idea. Did you know that student teacher, written with a hyphen, means a student who is also a teacher? Hyphens indicate compound nouns. If you want to talk about a student-teacher ratio, you need an N dash to indicate a coordinate noun, which is a pair of nouns which retain their original meaning but function as a single adjective. Did you know that you have to use an N dash in place of a hyphen when you're affixing a prefix to a proper adjectival phrase? An N dash signifies that the prefix applies to all words with a capital letter, not just the first word. This knowledge haunts me at night, like a really pathetic version of the telltale heart. Now, I won't pick someone up on subtle distinctions like these, but I can't ignore how confusing it is to see someone use unspaced hyphens in place of unspaced M dashes. Those characters in that context have opposite meanings, and it makes people's writing really difficult to read, especially when they're using hyphens as hyphens in the mix. Here is, for example, a paragraph displaying the often encountered error. This is how it sounds in my head. Here is, for example, a paragraph. Hang on, that's not right. Here is, for example, a paragraph displaying the often encountered. That isn't right either. Here is, for example, a paragraph displaying the often encountered error. There we go. That was a flippin' nightmare. If you really must use hyphens, put some spaces around a pair of hyphens, but that looks really messy, so it's better to just use the alt codes 0150 for N dashes and 0151 for M dashes, or Unicode +2013 and +2014, respectively. Speaking of being hard to read, the hyphen and the minus sign are not the same as far as screen readers are concerned. If you really want your writing to be accessible, and you should, you need to be using the alt code 8722 or the Unicode string +2212 to type your minus sign, and only use the key on your keyboard to type hyphens. If you don't use any other alt codes, please at least use those three codes to differentiate between hyphens, minus signs, and dashes. In addition to being less confusing, it also just looks better and it doesn't take that much longer to type. Another one I love is 0133, or +2026 in Unicode, which gives you ellipses. Contrary to popular belief, ellipses are not three full stops. They are a character in their own right. Now, a lot of word processors like Microsoft Word and Google Docs will change three full stops into ellipses for you automatically. But a platform that doesn't do that is Twitter. I've saved myself so many characters over the months just with this one alt code. Another great alt code is 0163, +0083 in Unicode, which gives you the symbol for the British pound. If you're not using a European keyboard, you probably don't have a dedicated pound key, but some of us still need to talk about finances in the United Kingdom. I certainly do, with all the reporting of British politics we do on the Trans Agenda. Those of you with connections to continental Europe may also benefit from 0128, which is +20AC in Unicode, which gives you the euro symbol. Finally, avid Pokemon fans like myself will get a lot of use out of the alt code 130, which gives you a lowercase acute e. In Unicode, this is +00E9. Those are just some of the conveniences alt codes and Unicode can offer, but there are hundreds more. Be creative! There are lists of alt codes and Unicode strings linked in the video description to get you started. Whatever you use them for, I just hope they bring a little bit of joy and convenience to your life. If you like this kind of attention to detail, and you'd like to support two creators who work tirelessly to bring you the most quality content we can, consider becoming a subscriber or patron of Essence of Thought, where most of my work can be found. I co-host fortnightly livestreams on there, I run the Essence of Community Discord, and I edit video scripts for content, structure, readability, tone, grammar and punctuation, formatting and accuracy. Since Ethel relies on Patreon in order to survive, donations really help me sleep at night, so I would be most grateful to anyone who can chip in, even if you can only give a dollar a month. Thank you for supporting my family.